My name is Dr. Cloe Gray. We're at Morehouse School of Medicine, and I'm a postdoctoral researcher in Dr. Katima Paul's lab. I'm originally from Kentucky. Kentucky is really beautiful. I really miss the horses that are there, the horse racing and the horse farms. I did love reading, and I remember climbing up trees and then reading books. I got interested in science when I was in eighth grade. I had a really tough eighth grade science teacher who really got me into science. She had all this lab equipment out, and it just kind of scared me because I was like, I don't know what's going on, I don't know what these are. But it really got me into science, and I did my doctorate at Georgia State University in Atlanta, Georgia. I like to find ways to solve issues that happen in today's society and contribute to the scientific community. I was introduced to this lab. We wanted to partner with the Paul Lab in some work that we were doing. I was interested in it because of the interaction between stress and sleep. Insomnia and nightmares are a big part of PTSD, and so that's one of our interests, is involving the intersection of stress and sleep, so that sleep can affect stress and stress can affect sleep. My mission is to figure out the mechanisms for sleep disorders and how stress impacts sleep, and how we can help people that have both sleep and psychiatric disorders to better their lives. We do experiments, and we analyze data, and we think of new experiments.
So we found that two major things, long-term sleep changes that occurred. It was increased REM and non-REM sleep.
We have programs that we can use to run statistics on our data and troubleshoot it and figure out the best way to go about answering that question. So you have to know exactly what the program is asking. Dr. Paul is a very supportive advisor. He's a lot more hands-on than what I was used to before. We were just working on an interesting model of PTSD and sleep disorders.
We know that sleep symptoms are a component of almost every depression affective disorder that there is.
I'm really happy with how things are going with the lab. I get really excited. I'll walk down and do a little dance in Chris's office. I'm like, yay, we got something, hooray. Probably 10% of the United States suffers from some sort of depressive or anxiety disorder. And there's a lot of people that still can't find treatment for that. So I think there's an era of personalized medicine coming up, and what we're doing with genetics and sleep could be very beneficial to people that are dealing with insomnia and other sleep disorders. I see it as kind of being a detective. What are the mysteries out there, and how can we best solve them using the scientific tools that we have? There's a lot of really interesting and cool techniques that we can use now. It's not just crunching numbers and doing that sort of thing. It's a lot of fun.